Hi friends, welcome to my channel Tech Easy Learning. Today we are going to see an important topic, that is Oracle Materialized View. First, what is a materialized view? I think you already heard about the view. Okay, I will tell you about what is materialized view, and then we can see the difference later. Yeah. The materialized view is a database object that contains the results of a query. Okay. It may be the local copy of the data located remotely. Materialized views are also known as snapshot. Materialized view are nothing but a snapshot of the data. Okay. This is the syntax. Okay. Before going into this materialized view, I will briefly explain, okay, what is the purpose of the materialized view. I have already created a video in view, and you can go through that. View is nothing but stored SQL statement. In view, we cannot store data, but in materialized view, we can store the data. Okay, that materialized view stores the data physically in the underlying table. There will be one underlying table attached to it so that you can easily store the data. Okay, it is nothing but a snapshot. Okay. Snapshot of data, how to refresh that periodically. Then only you can get the latest data. What is the main usage of this materialized view? For example, when we are working on two different databases, that is remotely located. Here we are having one local database, that is in our, we can say Chennai or Bangalore. And we are having one more database at US or UK. Okay. If you want to access the data frequently, the UK based server means the network traffic will be more. Normally, you know about in real time environment, there will be some millions of records. It's not like our ordinary environment. If you go for very big companies, there will be millions of records. When you query the table, suddenly the data will load and the network traffic will be more. The load will be more. And it takes more time to get the results also. So better we create the materialized view on the remote database table. Okay. We will create one materialized view on the remote table so that we can get the copy of the data in our local database. There is no need to get all the information. We want to have some details. In the real-time environment, we will be having some around 30 columns in the table. We don't want to have all the columns. Just we will create one view based on some important columns. I mean, we will get some important details from the remote, and we will keep the copy here. So whenever we query the data that is coming from our local system, so there is no need to worry about the network problems or network load, etc. But we need to refresh the materialized view in our local system regularly. So it is the network loads. No need of accessing the remote data. And we can also get the required data. These are all the purpose and the benefits of the materialized view. We can take the examples of the sales data, which we can get it refreshed either on daily basis or weekly. It depends upon the business requirement. Okay. Now we will see about the materialized view syntax. This is the materialized view syntax that is available here itself. Okay. If we go to the manual, you can get the full syntax, that means along with all options. Normally for the learning persons, if you directly go to the Oracle manual, refer the manual, it will be confusing for you. We have to take some important options and we need to try that one. For example, create table name, then primary key, then foreign key, then check constraints, a lot of things will be there. But for the first time, you have to use the create table name, then only one or two columns. Like that, but we have to go with the simple syntax. Create materialized view name. After that, you have to go for the build. Just a second. Create materialized view. Materialized view name is the basic syntax. And build immediate / defer. There are two options. Okay. I think you are able to see that my PPT. As soon as the materialized view is created, data is populated at our local table. Okay. Immediately. Deferred means during the first refresh. Okay. During the first refresh only, the data will be populated. And then refresh, fast, complete, and post. Three options are there. Fast, when the data change in the remote table, that means that is remotely located either in UK or US. Whenever the data is changed over there, it will be very quick. If you refresh it, what all the changes made, only it will be reflected. Okay. The complete means the complete data. Then the data what we are having in the local database will be truncated, removed, and fresh. It will get populated. All of fresh, it will get populated. Force means, what is the force? If it go and try the option fast, if it is not working properly, then it will go ahead with the complete option. Okay. Complete means repopulating the data fully. It will delete all the data in the local table and repopulate it on commit or demand. What is this? Whenever the data in the remote table is committed, here it will be automatically reflected. But it is not a good practice. Okay. We don't know what will be the impact. If suddenly some thousand rows gets updated and next day only one row is getting updated, so there will be some impact. So better go for the on-demand. On-demand means we can refresh our database at our convenience. But database means we can refresh our materialized view at our convenience so that we will get the new data, whatever the data that is required, we will get our convenience. Okay, it depends upon the business requirement. We can do it daily or once in a week. It depends upon our requirement. Okay. Then one more option is that disable query rewrite. It is not required at present. I am not going to, but disable query rewrite. That means we are going to change the query itself for the performance driven. Okay. That I am not going to use. And we are going to use the select star from. We have to give that which schema and then department. Here I am going to select the table in the Benz schema. I am having two schemas, demo and Benz. In the Benz schema, one table is called a department table. I am going to use that. I will show you how to update it and that how the updated data is getting reflected in the materialized view in our demo schema. Okay. There is one package available, BBMS materialized view refresh. Using that package, we can refresh the data regularly. Now we will go with the example. Yep. There are two schemas, Benz and demo is there. Okay. It's not required actually. Here I have created that materialized view, not created. Here I have already syntax I have used here, so that you can easily understand. Here create materialized view, name is mv_department. Then build immediate. Already I explained about immediate/deferred. Then refresh fast. There are three options: fast, complete, and pause. Here we are going with the fast option. And on demand, there are two options: on demand and commit. I've already explained it. Then disable query rewrite is not required. Anyway, I mentioned I've used it. And as select star from then start department. Here we are having the table. Yeah, there are around 4 records are there. Okay. 4 records are available: sales, shipping, finance, and operations. Okay. I will show you how to update it. I will show you after updating it how it is getting reflected in the materialized view. Okay, and also how to refresh by using that package. Okay. Before that, we have to create the materialized view. Here there is an option called a materialized view. Go to this tree view. Here then says that you go to demo user, and demo you can see. See here materialized view is there already. Materialized the view is available, I think. Already we have got one materialized view already created by some other purpose. I will drop it now. If you will see from the scrap. See, materialized view is not available now. Now we are going to create the materialized view. Before that, we have to make sure that this table is created with log option. That materialized view log option is there. You have to create the table with the log option. This is the syntax for that. Already I have created it. Materialized view log on the department table. Then the materialized view log will be created. Otherwise, we cannot create the materialized view in this schema, because we are going to create the materialized view not in this schema. We are going to create the materialized view of this table. This is a remote table. We are just thinking like that. Learning environment only, no? So the schemas will be locally located only. So in the real-time environment, it will be remotely located. So you have to use connected to the schema. That is why I mentioned that bins.dept. Before that, you have to make sure that log is created. Materialized view log is created on the department table. Already have created it. Okay. Now we are going to create the materialized view. Materialized view created. Let me will refresh here. See, the materialized view has got created. And for data, it will be populated. I already told when we that the options are there, no? Build immediate like that. So it is immediately getting populated. What we have to do is we are going to add one more data in the bins schema in the table department. We will check whether it has got getting updated. And the bin schema is there, tables department. See, this is a log table. That M log is there, no? This is the materialized view log. While creating the table, it won't be available. After creating the table, we have to use that create materialized view log so that that log table will be created. Without that log, we cannot create the materialized view table in the demo schema. Yeah. Yeah, there is no. What is that? No, sorry, I clicked on the materialized view log. Here the data is that around four records are there. We are going to add one more record, that is 50. I will put sales. Then I will put Pune. Normally you use the insert statement, then only it will be easy. Here it is learning environment I'm using like this. Real time you cannot use like this. Okay. Insert. I have inserted one sales department. Then we will check in the demo schema. In this view, only four records are available. What we have to do is we have to do the refresh. Package available already. Okay. Yeah, there is one package that is exe_materialized_view.refresh, and you have to pass the materialized view name, then we can get it refreshed. Now I am going to execute it. Let we will see the result. Success. Yeah. Now we are going to get the data. Awesome. See, now five records are there. The sales department got updated in our materialized view. Okay, this is the way you have to refresh the materialized view. Okay, so far we have seen the syntax, what is materialized view, what is the purpose of this, how to implement the materialized view in our local system. Okay, I will tell the difference between view and materialized view in our next video. Go through this, practice several times, then the materialized view will be very easy for you. We can use in our real-time environment. Even if they ask you an interview, you can easily answer. Okay, kindly go through my channel and share the videos and kindly support my channel. Thanks. Bye.